tonight. Somebody turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, he's able. Tell somebody else, he's able.
Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. Are you happy to be in the house of the Lord? Are you happy to be in the house of the Lord? I want you to greet this person seated by you and say that you are already transformed. Just tell the person. Hallelujah. At this very time, if you are outside, I want you to come inside. Let's maintain order. Small. The fact that you are dancing, it doesn't mean you have to walk out. Let's all sit down. So if you are outside, if you are general, you are outside, please make sure you are inside. I want the general seat to be filled. There are a lot of spaces and it doesn't glorify God. Amen. Okay. So for those of you at the back, I want you to come forward. Let's fill the seat. I don't know whether those people who have left the seat, they are going to come back. Are they going to come back? Okay. So let's maintain order in the house of God. Yes. If you are passing by, you want to come inside. Yes, come. There are a lot of seats for you. There are a lot of seats for you. What God is doing here, I'm telling you. How many of you heard the woman of God speaking? Did you hear? Did you hear what she said? If you really heard what she said, then there is no need to come and stand here. Because what she was saying was actually everything that God wanted to say. I'm telling you. Serious. That is why I don't like people to walk outside when the wind is coming. So when the gay people were leaving, I was very sad. Because they missed everything. The real substance. That is what they just, when she took their mind, they just left. I was very sad. But I know you get them the tips. Try and get them the tips so that they will listen to what she said. So before I do everything, you know, this vision is not coming from me. This whole vision about finance, about influencing our world and raising 1 billion intercessors and all these things, it's not coming from me. There's a man of God. Somebody say, man of God. Say, the Lord gave the word, and great is the multitude. Huh? So one man carried the vision, but there are a lot of people who must hold the vision and put it across. So we are all carriers of the vision. Amen. But the one who received the mandate, I want us all to stand. It's not here, but stand on your feet, wherever you have to stand. And we are giving honor to whom honor is due, respectfully, to the man of God. Pastor, Prophet, Bona, and Kaiser. He's my father, and wherever I stand, I owe him a lot of gratitude. What are we telling you wherever he is? But what are we telling you wherever he is? Let's give him a big ahoya. Aho! Hey, the room is charged. My God, I can feel fire in your bones. You are going to devour the devil when you see him. I see you devouring the devil in the name of Jesus. You go to your school when the devil show up, you will touch him alive and eat him. Somebody clap your hands for me in the name of Jesus. You might take your seat. So the other generals, we have Pastor Fifi Obey, Pachin, who's also there, deputy director, right? Yeah, then our pastor is here. It's, when we're in here, no, this one of God called Commander Fire. My God, any prayer he prays, he will add by fire by tether. One day, one man showed up, causing trouble when he went to size. He was telling you, this one was of one I cry. I'm exposing you. This man was doing this confusion. This man of God appeared. Somebody say he appeared. When he appeared, and this man was doing confusion, he said, by fire, come down. gift that under the anointing. And he cast the devil and said, come out by fire. And then my God, come on, give it up to the man of God. He's one of our donor pastors. He's in charge of the whole Western region and Central region. So he's the pastor hosting us. Amen. So most of you don't know him, but he's the pastor in charge of all the campuses and the senior high schools and all that. So let's give it up to him, Pastor Joshua. When you see your pastor, say Pastor Joshua, greet him. He carries a strange anointing upon his heart. I'm telling you, the day you mount this puppet, you guys are going to take loads and carry it to the house. Amen. He also heard from Pastor Zach. General Zach, right? General. Oh, come on, give it up for him. You see, when Mercy finished and he took the microphone, did he hear what he said? You wait, and then he will catch you. You see what he did to you. He slowed it. Amen. Amen. Then also to all the PN what? SA generals. Wait, also for stand on your feet. Also for stand. The one that Albert. Sorry. It's called Albert. You see, this man is robust. He carries a lot of things inside him. When it comes to leadership, it's an expert today. Let's give it up for him. He's the one that has made sure that all these things will come. God bless you. God bless you. Are you ready for the word? Oh, are you ready for the word? Okay. I want us to read, we are going to read about three scriptures and I will just show you to it. John chapter 15, verse 19. Then Genesis chapter 4, verse 1. Then Romans chapter 4, verse 2. John 15, 19. Genesis 12, 1. Romans 12, verse 2. So I show you myself reading. Now the Lord said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto the land I will show thee. This is Genesis 4, verse 1. Genesis 12, 1 is the one I read. Then John chapter 15, verse 19. It said, if you were of the world will love his own. But because you are not of the world, but because he are not of the world, and I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world will hate you. Somebody say, I have been chosen out of the world. So shout it very well, say it very well. Very good. Then let's go to Romans chapter 12, verse 2. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. Romans 12, verse 22. Shall be not conformed to this world, but be what? Transformed by the renewing of your mind, that he may prove what is good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. As of all, you know that there's going to be a revival. This revival that we are going to see in our generation is not going to be a religious revival. Listen, we have heard of Azusa Street, we have heard of the Wales revival, we have heard of a lot of John Wesley revival and the Great Awakening in America. They are all revivals. But this one we are going to see is not going to be a revival that is going to be involved in the pulpit, where people are going to preach and people are going to follow the anointing. Yes, that one is part of the revival. But this is a revival that is going to push into all the sectors. So in the political sector, there will be revival. In the health sector, there will be revival. In the education sector, there will be revival. In the engineering sector, there will be revival. In every sector that we have in this world, there is going to be a revival. Why? Because the sons of God are going to occupy these places and cause a revival over there. If you believe it, shout a big amen. If you believe it, shout a big amen. So how many of you want to be part of this revival? Do you want to be part? Oh, you want to position yourself to be part? Okay, put your hands down. So when Haman was singing, Mount Zion, higher than what? The mountains, the joy of God, every nation. I was sitting down there and I was saying, hey, this woman, where is Mount Zion? Where is Mount Zion? I will say that out of Zion, the perfection of beauty. That is where the Lord shines forth. Out of Mount Zion. The joy of many nations. Beloved, Jesus said that I'm chasing you out of the world. And God was telling Abraham to come out of his family. So where is he coming from? Coming out of your family doesn't mean that move from here to America. The fact that you have left your family to America doesn't mean you are not part of the family. Huh? Then it means that when you came to this, you are not part of the family, no? So it might mean more than that. So if God is telling Abraham that Abraham come out of your family, of your father's house, then he is talking about something higher. Somebody say something higher. Something higher. And Jesus is saying that I'm chasing you out of this world. Out of this world. So you see, what I want to share is, before you can be able to influence this world, you need to come out of it. Because you cannot be part of the water and change water. Is it possible? How can a water particle change the water? It is only when you introduce another substance into the water, that is the water, that thing will influence it. So for instance, you can put a dye inside water and the whole water will change color. Why? Because the dye has influenced it. Meaning that the dye is of a different substance than the water. Hello? So you cannot be part of your friends, think like your friends, behave like your friends and influence them. How can you be so? Are you listening to me? Hello? Or am I communicating? Yes. So if we are all chickens, how can chicken influence chickens? But when another thing is introduced, another person is introduced. So he said, I'm choosing you out of the world. God knew that if you want, you see, the reason why God is choosing Abraham, is choosing Abraham was because he wanted to pass through Abraham to influence the whole world. But Abraham cannot influence the whole world if he is part of the Father's house. Somebody say, come out. What about 3.10? Come out, come out. Say, come out. So how do we come out? How do we come out? The first way to come out is to be born again. Yes. Until you are born again, there is no way. You got to be born again. Tell your brother, you have to be born again. Nicodemus went to Jesus. He told him, hey, you must be born again. Why would Jesus be able to influence the world? Because he was not of the world. He came as a different seed. All men of come for the same seed, but Jesus was of a different seed. He wasn't coming from the loins of Adam. He was coming from the loins of God. Hallelujah. And because he was coming from the loins of God, he lived a different life. And thank God that just as Jesus was of a different seed, you can be of a different what? Seed. How? The Bible said, as many as receive him, as many as believe in him, he gave them what? The power, the exousia, to become what? To become the sons of God. And I continue. Okay, so I'm reading John 1, verse 12 to 13. So let me go. So as the Bible says, it's a children not born of flesh, not born out of the will of man. They are not born of blood, but they are born of God. That is to say, ye are of God, little children, and ye have overcome them. For greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. If you are born again, I'm telling you, you will touch the world in the name of Jesus. Oh, only a few people heard it. Those few people who shout amen. I see God using you to do a great thing. As you are shouting amen, I see the power of God. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Not born out of the will of man. They are not born of blood. But they are born of God. Somebody say, I want the life of God in me. So these ones are different beings. Let me tell you, if you are a believer, you are not like the ordinary person. You are different. But the problem is that when you become born again, you need to be able to come to your identity. That is the problem. Because it's only a few people who have been able to come to their true identity. Somebody say identity. Good. So we are looking at the word transform. Somebody say transform. And science students, where are you? Lift up your hands and see you. Science students. Good. They are all over the place. You heard of the word metamorphosis, right? What is metamorphosis? From one stage to what? Another. Right? You see, I was with my friend, Osofu Ebe. And Osofu Ebe was seriously looking for DNA, whatever. And I was saying, Osofu Ebe, why are you looking for DNA? So I want to check whether the DNA of that larvae, science am I right? Yes. Larvae, right? Uh-huh. And the butterfly are the same. Because until their DNA becomes the same, then how can the larvae become a butterfly? Are you hearing me? So I was doing the space search with you. So last week was a chance of research. Then we found it out. Somebody say we found it out. What we saw concerning the larvae and the butterfly, the difference was that according to the scientists, their DNA are the same. But it's just that their features, the one of the larvae, they are not fully developed. So it means that he has the same capacity as the butterfly. He can fly as the butterfly. He can be beautiful as the butterfly. But because his features are not fully developed, he's going to limit himself. But when he undergoes metamorphosis, he begins to come to his true identity. Then he becomes a butterfly. Then he begins to sign as a butterfly. Talk like a butterfly. Fly like a butterfly. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? So until you undergo transformation, there is no way you can be able to come to your true identity. And that is when the influence begins to come. Negative. So it means that, listen. So in the Christendom, you see they are seniors. Someone said they are seniors. They are seniors. We have men of God who are raising the dead, who are casting animals. You watch Pastor Chris and you are like, we're looking for human beings like you and me. When they didn't go to school, they went to school. But the only difference between you and them is that yours, you have the same capacity to cast out devils, to develop. But today, as you are hearing us and as we are teaching you, I see all those features that are not fully developed, developing in the name of Jesus. And in the years to come, we are not going to watch Pastor Chris on TV, but we are going to watch you on TV. Pastor our couples, raising the dead, doing all the miracles that people are doing. These signs are followed and not believed. In my name, they will cast out devils. They will raise the dead. I'm telling you, we are not going to look at this people again, but it's going to be you. I said it's going to be you. If you believe, stand on your feet and give me your loudest shout in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
man of prayer and fasting. So when Mercy was talking about prayer, I don't know whether you heard what he was saying. Okay, so let me talk. Those who are at the back, first and coming shy. Listen, okay, let's continue. So, Abu Shaw said, he fasted for 3 days, for these ones. And he knew their spots, where they do their case. So after 3 days fasting the prayer, he went there. And when he went there, there were all the smokes going on. You see, the whole place was saturated with the atmosphere of marijuana. And Abu Shaw said, he just stated the word. He said, God loves you. And he left. That's all. He didn't say anything. He just said, God loves you. And he said, God told him that they will come and search for him. And true to the word, all the boys over there came searching for Abu Shaw. And his dilemma was part of it. So he was the one who led him to Christ. He was a witch worker. And now look at what this one is doing. There are a lot of people who are Christians, but they have not been able to do that. I see somebody whom the world has rejected, whom the world doesn't say anything about. Oh, be coming to Christ and impacting the world for him. Come on, receive it in the name of Jesus. So God doesn't condemn anyone. God is not condemning you because you are not pious and you are not you see, I wrote something now. I said, when we say come to Christ, we are not telling you to come and wear long dresses. Huh? Come and don't wear earrings. Are you listening? Come and don't pedicure and manicure your eyes. No. When we call you to come to Jesus, we are calling you to beauty. We are calling you to glory. We are calling you to power. We are calling you to be partaker of divinity. We are calling you to righteousness. The Bible said, they that receive the gift of what? The gift of righteousness. And the abundance of grace, they will reign in life. I see you reigning in the name of Jesus. I see you reigning in the name of Jesus. I see you reigning in the name of Jesus. There is a call from poverty to riches. A call from beauty, from ashes to beauty. If you have been crying all your years, wait until you test this water. The Bible said there is a water whose streams make glad. It is the city of God. When you have Jesus, this water will come inside you and your sorrow will turn into dancing. I see you dancing the rest of your life. In the name of Jesus, somebody shout a big amen. For God has not given us the spirit of fear and timidity, but the spirit of love, of power, and of a sound mind. I see you excelling in the name of Jesus. Somebody clap your hands for Jesus.
One TV, feeding the world with the gospel.